You have now seen some examples of covariance matrices, all with covariances equal to zero. But what does it mean if the covariances are not equal to zero? In order to understand that, we need to look at how the covariance of two variables is defined. As you can see from the formula in blue, it is equal to the correlation coefficient of two variables multiplied by their standard deviations. The correlation coefficient is a value between minus 1 and 1, and the following examples explain how to interpret its value. Let's assume that the standard deviation of two random variables are 1 and 2 respectively, and the correlation coefficient is said to be equal to rho. Then, from the definition, we know that the covariance is equal to 2 times the correlation coefficient. The first value for rho we choose is 0. This plot shows then 10,000 outcomes for the random vector with these given standard deviations and correlation coefficient. The horizontal axis refers to E1, the vertical axis to E2. Note that the mean values are indicated along those axes. Since the standard deviation of the second variable is twice that of the first variable, also the spread in that direction is twice as large. But since the two variables are uncorrelated, rho is zero, knowing the outcome of, for example, E2 does not give a clue on the expected outcome of E1. It may take a quite large range of values, as visualized by the red line. Now let's look at another extreme, where the two variables are fully correlated. Rho is equal to 1. The range of values that the individual variables can take is still the same, but now the two random variables have a linear relation. Knowing the outcome of one variable will give you the exact value of the other variable. Now an example with rho between 0 and 1. Then you would get this. We can see that knowing the outcome of E2 limits the range of values that E1 can take, indicated again by the red line. Moreover, in this case, E2 is larger than the mean. This gives you a high likelihood that E1 will be larger than its mean as well. This is because of the positive correlation indicated by rho equal to 0.7. If, on the other hand, the two variables would have a negative correlation, we would get the opposite, as seen in the plot on the left-hand side. A value larger than the mean for E1 will more likely give you a smaller than the mean for E2, and vice versa. Now let's look at the distribution of the random errors. As we saw before, a single random error follows the normal distribution, with mean 0 and a certain standard deviation. This is the univariate normal distribution. How about the multivariate case, where we are interested in the distribution of a vector of m random errors? This vector will follow the multivariate normal distribution, which depends on the vector with mean values, in this case the zero vector, and the covariance matrix. In a two-dimensional case, we can still visualize this normal PDF. For higher dimensions, we cannot. Therefore, we will look at this example, where we collect one laser distance measurement with high precision and one rope measurement with much lower precision. The corresponding PDF looks like this. On the left, you can see a surface plot, and on the right, a top view. The larger standard deviation of the rope measurement results in a larger spread in the vertical direction of this plot. In the exercises, you will look at different examples of covariance matrices and the multivariate normal PDF for the two-dimensional case. And then in the next lecture, we will go back to our estimation problem and identify the different elements of this problem.